Hey guys, welcome back. I am going to do another little makeup video for you today. It is my day off, so I woke up around probably 9:15, I think, and I instantly started cleaning my house probably till about 11, then I just jumped in the shower, and now I'm trying to like wind down a little bit because it is my day off and I do want to like relax and stuff, so yeah, and I've been really busy most of the morning. Like, I literally just ate and took a shower and did all that stuff. So I'm going to try to film... Well, I'm going to film this makeup video. I'm going to kind of try to relax and, like, zen out a little bit. And then after this video, I'm going to do another video. And my other video is going to be... I'm kind of excited about my second video because it is going to be, like, on my art channel as well. I'm thinking about uploading it to the second channel and to my art channel. The video that I'm gonna film after this is a bullet journal video. I'm gonna try to start bullet journaling, and I'm gonna set up my bullet journal and I'm gonna show you guys what I'm gonna do. My spread and everything that I've kind of came up with. I haven't done it yet. I have an idea of how I'm gonna do it. But I'm gonna make it all artsy fartsy and cool for you guys, and I think maybe after this video I'm gonna show you a sneak peek of a drawing that I've been doing. So yeah, I think that's pretty much it. If you guys hear anything crazy in the background, my dogs are going insane. So yeah, and like I wanna like say this too, like it's been snowing and like raining a lot here, and all the snow is melted and it is so muddy outside, so my dog like goes outside, gets super muddy, comes in and tracks it in, and it's so fucking annoying. Like, oh my god, it's the most annoying thing because I can't keep those little mud prints like off my floor. It's driving me crazy, you guys. So okay, I think that's like my little spiel. I am going to get started. Alright, so let's start the video. Okay, so I just dampened my sponge. I got a little paper towel to clean my brushes off in between. And I also have some tunes on YouTube because I'm trying to like relax, so I need some calming vibes. Okay, so I do have an idea of what I want to do. I'm thinking, I haven't really dove into this palette yet. It is the Sultry Profusion palette. I really want to dig into some of these purples over here, these dark, deep purples. I don't know if you can see that because the glare. Maybe I can close this a little bit. Okay. Yeah, I don't know if you can see this on my camera, but there's some really good purples on this side that I really want to get into, and I want to get all these smoky eyes out of my system because spring is just around the corner, and I'm going to be doing like more natural looks with like bright lips, and I just want to get all this get all these smoky eyes out of my system. So, and also I'm going to be using, instead of the foundation that I've been obsessed with and love, instead of using this one, I'm going to use the Infallible Pro Matte, just because I don't love this one as much and I really want to use it up because I'm probably not going to repurchase it. So I'm going to use that up, and you got to work fast with this one, and it doesn't really give your skin that really good look, so I don't know. It looks dry and kind of not very great for me, so. Okay, yeah, it's not bad. It actually isn't terrible, but the main reason I don't really like this foundation is because I have really big pores, and since it's a matte foundation, it kind of settles into my pores funny, and I'm not really super, like, impressed with that. I don't know if you could see it on camera, but, like, it kind of gets into my pores and looks weird. So yeah. Okay, the next product I'm gonna go in with is this Candid Revlon Concealer. Yeah, I'm not gonna go super crazy with the concealer today, even though that's already kind of crazy. Okay, my dogs are stressing me out. They're way too hyper right now. Okay. So I'm gonna do a light dusting of powder just because I don't feel like this matte foundation, it doesn't really need to be set, but I just put some concealer on, so I'm just gonna lightly powder my face. And I'm going to use this Infallible Pro Matte L'Oreal powder. I love this stuff. I've pretty much been using this stuff exclusively like all month, so. Okay, I actually think that looks pretty good. It doesn't look too bad. I forgot to cover this little guy up right here. I don't know if you can see, but you know what? I think he could stay. I'm not really super, maybe I will cover him up actually. Okay, he's pretty much gone. Okay. Alright, you guys, I'm gonna do my brows and I'm gonna be right back. Okay, and I'm back. I know I probably look a little crazy right now because of the white powder. But I just did my brows, I primed my eyelids because I used the bright purples in the Wonderlust palette and they did stain my eyes, so I put some primer on and some powder to hopefully, I don't know if the dark colors, the dark purples are gonna stain my eyes. I don't think they will, but just in case, I primed my eyes and powdered so my eyelids are safe. And then I put some powder on. I kind of look like a crack addict, but it's okay. So yeah, that's what I did. And now I'm gonna get on to the eyeshadow. So I do want to say this first. Before I applied this foundation, I did exfoliate my face and I shaved my face, and I did shave my face in the shower and exfoliated and moisturized. This is setting on my skin pretty good. If you do wear this, decide to purchase this, it's not bad. It looks pretty natural. I would say this is probably the best matte foundation in the drugstore. But just make sure your skin is exfoliated, moisturized, and I recommend shaving your face because having makeup like cling and like get weird around like little hair follicles on your face, like it doesn't look very good. And I mean, I have pretty thick peach fuzz and I try to remove that. But yeah, it just makes your foundation look so much better, I've noticed. So I highly recommend that, and that's what I did to like prep my skin for this foundation. So alright, let's get started with the eyeshadow. Man, I'm like really tempted to use some of those greens. Those greens are so pretty. You know what? I think I'm actually gonna stick with my guns today and do the purples. I'll test these greens out later, because these greens are super pretty. I'm gonna go in with these purples today though, because I really want to try these out. But I haven't really dove into this palette, so I don't really know how good it is. If anybody is wanting full palette reviews and swatches and a bunch of different looks with these Profusion palettes, let me know and I'll do those. It's just there's so many on the internet and I don't know if one more opinion really matters, but who knows. So, alright, I'm going in with Canny and I'm gonna put that under my brow bone and in my inner whatever this is. Inner corner of your eye, there we go. God, that little shade has so much fallout, it is ridiculous. Okay, now I'm gonna take the color, I think I'm gonna go in with Adventurous right here. It's kind of this like mustardy, nudie brown color. I don't know if that's the best way to describe that color, but I'm gonna put this in my crease with a little dome shaped brush just to kind of start getting some dimension on the eyes, so. Okay, so that's what we have so far. I think I'm gonna go in with Bewitched, this really dark purple color. I'm gonna put that on my lid. That is really dark. Okay, I'm definitely very underwhelmed with this color. It didn't go on as pigmented as I thought it was gonna go on, and it took me a while to build this up. Like, I really had to struggle to build this up. It was kind of dry and it wasn't really like that buttery, like you know, glides on your lid type consistency. So, I mean, I got there in the end, but it is kind of patchy and I'm not super in love with this color. But, I mean, you could build it up and get something, but it's not, and it's staining my finger, which is kind of surprising. So, all right, so the next color I'm gonna try out is Nimble, and I'm gonna put that in my crease. Okay, so that was a little bit better, but I can definitely see that I lost some of Bewitched, so I'm gonna go back in with that and try to build that up again. Okay, so we definitely built that up and we got there, but I've played with some of these grays at the very end, and they're really patchy too, so unfortunately that kind of seems like a theme with this palette that I've noticed. It's very patchy and it's not very pigmented. Not everything in here is a miss, but, these browns are really good. I haven't really played with these blues or these greens yet, and I do like these lighter colors over here, so I'm gonna keep testing out this palette. So far, these purples, you can get there, and it does look kinda nice, but they're kinda hard to work with, and they're very patchy. And these grays, which kind of made me sad, because these grays look really pretty. But yeah. So, I'll keep playing with this palette, and I'll let you know guys, so I'm gonna go back in with Adventurous and kind of clean up the edges out here. I think I'm gonna go in with that light color and dust it out here under my brow bone just to kind of re-emphasize that again. Can you get to the fallout on my cheek is like unreal, like that is ridiculous. So I think I'm happy for the top lid for the most part. You know, it could be better. Those purples don't look too bad once you get them there, but just, they're hard to work with. So I'm gonna clean up this under eye area and then I'm gonna work on the lower lash line. Actually, I'm gonna work on the lower lash line first because I feel like if I move this powder, it's gonna be a mess. So I don't think I'm gonna do anything too crazy underneath there. So I think I'm just gonna take this slanted brush, and you know what? Since I wanna play with these blues, I think I'm gonna take Lagoon and put it on my lower lash line just to see how that looks. We'll have a blue purpley look going on. And that is on my lower lash line, so it's kind of hard to tell, but it doesn't look too bad under there, so. Okay, now I'm gonna clean up this under eye. I'm gonna take a little bit more of Adventurous and actually blend it a little bit better out here. Yeah, I just want to make sure things kind of blended together. My eye shape's kind of hard to work with because I have very, like, small eyes and they don't really, they're very, like, round also, so it's kind of hard to get the shadow to get around my eye and look halfway decent, so. Okay, so the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to bronze up my face, and I'm going to do that with the Milani Bronzing Powder. I don't really love this. It works, the tone is really pretty, but my problem is it gets patchy if you press too hard. So I have to go in with like a light hand with this one. I could see it trying to get patchy, and which is kind of ridiculous because I just exfoliated and shaved my face. So there's like nothing for it to really cling to, so it's kind of annoying. I really want to try the Butter Bronzer so bad from Physicians Formula. I think I'm going to pick that up maybe this weekend. Okay, so I just blended out that bronzer, and I did some powder down here for some light veiling. So now I'm gonna work on the lashes, the liner, and the cheeks. So pretty much the upper half of my face I'm gonna move back to and start working on that again. I'm gonna take a slanted brush like this and some gel liner. I am using Maybelline Eye Studios gel liner. This is okay, it's not the best, but it's not the worst. It definitely gets the job done. So I think I might do a slight wing just because when I do a heavy lower lash line, it drags my eyes down, so I'm gonna try to bring them back up again, so. And plus I haven't done a wing in probably a couple weeks, so I'm excited to do a wing again. things are really hard for me to do because my eye shapes are very different. Like, I have very different looking eyes, so to try to get them even is actually kind of hard, so. One of my eyes is, like, up higher and larger than the other one, so it's kind of hard to get them even looking. So, I'm definitely rusty at doing the wings, but I think it'll be okay. These can be messy wings. I don't mind messy wings sometimes. It all looks a little messy, so it's okay. Okay. Next, I'm gonna do some mascara. I'm just using CoverGirl X. I can't say that fucking word. I'm sorry, you guys. I'm using this mascara. So. Oh my gosh, you guys. I just got it on my cheek. Oh. I know you're supposed to let it dry, but I don't want to do that. Fuck, it never looks the same. Oh well. Okay, I'm like fairly happy with the eyes. I think they look okay. I think the shadow, now that I'm looking at it, looks really good. It's just hard to work with and hard to build up. My little wings are looking a little rough, but we got there in the end. This can be a messy, smoky eye. I definitely need to practice wings again. I kind of got lazy doing my makeup in the morning to go to work, and I stopped doing wings, so it's my first wing in, like, probably about a month, so. Okay, next I'm gonna do highlighter, blush, and then lips. Okay, for highlighter, I'm going up this e.l.f. Dream Glow Beam Palette thing. I got this on clearance a couple weeks ago. I really have been enjoying this. I mix all these colors down here together. The only colors that I'm gonna probably do a bit of a review on this, but I really do enjoy this, and I'm actually gonna mix this with another highlighter. Still see a dark spot right there. That is so annoying. Hopefully this highlight will cover it up a little bit. And I know this may not be for everybody, but I really like to do this because I'm like an extra type of person, but I'm gonna go in with this. It's called Royal something, by Wet n Wild. It's pretty much just a lavender highlight. It is really pretty, and I don't like to use it by itself because it's a little too much, but I do like to blend it in with my other highlights, just so when I turn my face, you see some lavender, and it's so pretty. So, I'm gonna go in with this. Mixed in with other highlights, it's so gorgeous. I definitely love, like, a bright, thick highlighter. It's just, it's my personal taste, I guess, but I really like it. So, and I think that just that subtle lavender with the purples looks so pretty. So, I like it. All right, next I'm gonna go with this Milani blush in Luminoso. This has turned into my favorite blush of all time. It is absolutely gorgeous. It's this shimmery peachy pink color and, like, coral. I wouldn't even say coral. It's more of a peach, like, pretty much a peachy blush. That's all I can describe it, but it is so pretty, and it's definitely turned into, like, my favorite blush of all time, so. Okay, yeah, I love that, you guys. It's so pretty. Okay. Oh, my back is so sore. Alrighty. Alright, now I'm gonna just remove this bake. Alright guys, one of my favorite things to do is lips, and I have been trying a bunch of lipsticks. I probably have like 20 over here that I'm trying, and I have fallen in love with a lot of these, actually, that I've purchased. One of them is Innocence. It's 60 by Milani, and is so, it actually doesn't look that, anything special, when I show it to you. There we go, that's a good, but it's like a nudie, a cool nude, actually. It is more of a cool nude, but they smell so good. They smell like vanilla, and this is the first time, like, I love how these smell. These and the Maybelline lipsticks smell so good, like, I'm digging it. Okay, so I'm gonna use that today, because I think it would look really good with this smoky eye that we got going on. So I'm gonna remove the chapstick on my lips and do some liner. And I've exfoliated my lips too, so my lips are pretty I'm pretty good right now. I've been pretty much using this Revlon Nudie Pink Liner for like almost all of these lipsticks. I need to get some more lip liners, but I've been liking it. I have a lip liner from Maybelline, but Maybelline lip liners dry my lips out so much. They look really nice, but my lips feel like hell after the end of the day, so this one dries them out a little bit, but it's nowhere near as bad as that Maybelline one, so. And I've been kind of doing a little line here to make my lips look fuller. I don't know if I like it yet, but I've definitely been trying. It smells so good. Okay, that is the lips. I'm gonna take a little bit of highlight and put it on my Cupid's bow. Alright, so I don't think I'm gonna do any setting spray just because when I use setting spray, it just feels really heavy and I'm gonna be just pitter-pattering around the house probably the rest of the day. I'm probably just gonna be working on like Instagram posts, my second video that I wanna do. I'm probably gonna clean. I might actually film cleaning my bathroom. I don't know if you guys really care about that stuff, but I like watching cleaning videos on YouTube, so it gets me motivated. So I don't know, maybe I'll make one for you guys too. All I have left to do is laundry and my bathroom, so yeah, I will show you the makeup and yeah, I'll be back in just a minute. Dogs have been so hyper throughout this whole makeup tutorial and now they're tuckered out. Oh, it's my massive pile of laundry. Woofies, are you comfortable? Are you comfortable? She needs a haircut. Okay. Alright guys, so this is the final look. I don't know if you can see, I'm trying to find good lighting. Alright, can you guys see that good? I hope this lighting isn't terrible. My camera's not the best. But yeah, this is the makeup look for today. I'm actually pretty happy with it. It turned out pretty good. That foundation actually is better than I remembered, but I think that has a lot to do with exfoliating and shaving my face and moisturizing before I even sat down to do this video, so. But it actually doesn't look too bad. I'm really surprised. I don't know why I kind of shunned that foundation. You know what I think it is, you guys? I think it's because this foundation has stolen my heart. And, like, everything that I've tried before this foundation, like, it just doesn't match up to this foundation. And this is all I want to use now. So, I think that's my problem. Every foundation just sucks to me now. Like, I have trouble even using these. And I loved this before. So, I don't know, you guys. I'm gonna work on another video. I'm gonna show you guys some art real fast. I'm probably gonna work on some Instagram posts because I'm really lazy at that. So, oh wait, I'll show you my little robe thing. I think it's cute. It's got some crazy sleeves. These sleeves are so cute, but they're so annoying because, like, when I'm doing stuff, like, I have to watch where they, like, sit. But yeah, I like them. I think it's cute. I've been trying to, wear more, like, cute little things around the house. Like, nice, cute little robes and stuff. And like wearing like cuter pajamas and stuff, like it's just like a thing that I'm trying to get into nowadays. But yeah, and I have like an outfit that I have specifically for cleaning that I've been wearing so I can feel extra bougie. I got my husband to say the word bougie now, which is hilarious. Okay, I'm gonna show you the other stuff and then we'll end the video. I forgot to show you guys the most badass slippers of all time.
Oh yeah. So hardcore.
Okay, you guys, here is a little sneak peek of another drawing that I've been working on. I don't want to show you guys too much because it's still a surprise. So yeah, I'm excited for this one, you guys. And I did do a little face painting for practice the other day, and I actually really like how this came out. I'll show you guys. I don't know if you can really see. Yeah, I think it's turned out pretty good. I like most of it. It's just practice. I haven't painted a face in a while, so I wanted to do that. I actually like how it came out, you guys. I'm sorry. I'll probably talk more about it later in another video, and I didn't record this one, unfortunately, but I will post it on my Instagram, so. Alright, you guys, I'm gonna get started working on more content for you, and oh my god, I'm so zoomed in. Hang on. And I'm losing my voice. Okay. So I'm working on more content for you guys. I'm kind of slow because I've been super, oh my god, super unorganized. That's why I was really inspired to do the whole bullet journal thing. Just because I wanted to be more organized and I wanted to balance out my like art, cleaning, working out, like life, and try to figure out how to relax in the midst of all that somewhere. So yeah, I'm just, you know, trying to work on stuff. I think that's all. I think that's it I have for you guys today. I hope you enjoyed the video. Please leave any recommendations for any videos in the future that you would like to see. And I will see you in the next one. Bye, guys.